Immediately after the exposure of the scam by journalists from Zerkalo Tyzhnya, Energy Minister Yuri Boyko, without blinking an eye, started to intimidate them with the Ukrainian security service. Let the terrible SBU deal with the unworthy scribblers who are sabotaging the extraction of domestic hydrocarbons from the Black Sea shelf.
We will ask the security service to find out who ordered these articles that do not allow us to increase our energy independence.
Meanwhile, realizing the true scale of the scandal, Naftogaz began covering up the transactions. The main message from the management was clear: additional equipment is being bought along with the rig.
Conditions are such that in addition to the rig, we are ordering equipment needed to work on other rigs, the second, third, and tenth. This includes helicopters, transportation, and so on. Naturally, that increases the price. The price of the basic rig is 250 million. That can be easily verified.
This, however, is complete nonsense. After all, the results of the tender are written in black and white. The $400 million purchased a self-lifting floating drilling rig, one unit only. That's all. If there was any additional equipment, it would have been recorded. It just doesn't happen otherwise. And even if more equipment and services had been purchased, it is difficult to imagine how they could be worth more than half the cost of the rig itself. Secondly, the tender result published by the Journal of State Procurement, $400 million for one platform, is an official document which itself is already undeniable proof that $150 million were overpaid for the rig. Moreover, officials are well aware that the offshore tender winner with Ukrainian roots, a simple fencing firm established for the purpose of winning the tender, is what compromises them the most.
They wanted to cover their tracks to show that this is a reputable company. But then suddenly you see that the British company created all this in Kyiv, registered the name in Kyiv, and it's all hosted on Ukrtelecom.
Just a reminder, on December 13 last year, Chornomornaftogaz declared an open tender for the purchase of a floating oil rig installation. Applications for participation were received from two companies, Highway Investment Processing LLP and Falcona Systems Limited. The latter's price was only $10 million higher, and of course it lost. Both companies are founded by offshore firms. What's more, as a result of a thorough investigation by Mirror of the Week journalists, it became obvious that the founders of both companies are the same surrogates – international financial swindlers from Latvia, Stan Gorin and Erik Vanagels. Now comes the fun part – the winning company Highway Investment Processing. Active bloggers have located the offices of the reputable trader that sells oil rigs worth $400 million through the internet service Google Street View. A sign on the building, a very modest one for such a well-established company, says it sells plumbing materials. But the fact that this firm is a dummy is best proven by its website. The suspicious webpage of the supposedly reputable trader from Britain had proven to be the weakest spot in this massive scam.
If not for this site, perhaps we would not have begun our inquiry.
Firstly, this page, which can only be called a travesty of a real website, was created just 2 weeks before the announcement of the tender results. Secondly, it indicates that Highway Investment is a large international company founded in Cardiff, Wales, in the United Kingdom. But the portal has Ukrainian hosting, i.e. registration, and was developed by designers from the company Delta X in Kyiv. In addition, the language of Shakespeare is distorted by rough lexical errors. Either the British trading rigs worth hundreds of millions of dollars are completely illiterate, or this is a clear sign of the primitive use of an automatic translation into English. The fact that something supposedly well-known and British originates in Ukraine is shown by another detail. When downloading images of the very same platforms from the site, files are assigned names that are not quite English, such as the symbol Tovar 1 and Tovar 2. When reporters ran them through a service of similar images, they discovered that these were actually rigs of a truly large Singaporean company called Keppel.
ці вишки бурильні.
These are a rare enough commodity. Their construction takes about 2 years. Only a couple is made each year, and so on. There are a limited number of manufacturers. We have found one website that sells rigs, and this rig was made by Keppel.
Де продаються вишки, що ця вишка підписана, що це є фірма Keppel.
The Singaporean company's website, in contrast to pages of fencing firms, is much more informative. It turns out that last year, on December 3rd, 10 days before the announcement of the tender procedure by Naftogaz, the company Keppel had just finished building a new drill set ordered by their permanent distributor, Sidril. The same one depicted in the photo with the funny signature Tawar 2. Actually, it is a Class B West Juno sea drilling rig, and on April 13 this year, after the completion of the Naftogaz tender procedure, Sidril happily reported on its website that it had sold the very same platform to an anonymous British buyer. The price? $248.5 million. The secret buyer, it seems, is the offshore highway investment processing, who resold the drilling platform to Chornomornaftogaz at $400 million, thus making $150 million on the state of Ukraine. But Naftogaz remains unmoved.
There is no such price. This is a phrase taken out of a complex agreement. There is a whole list of items.
Чого туди входить?
Are you willing to openly show where the $150 million went to?
If it's necessary.
This is what you should have done a long time ago, Mr. Bakulin. The head of Naftogaz even reached the point of absurdity. He said that the money was transferred directly to the maker plant in Singapore, not to the intermediary in Cardiff.
Сама платформа.
As of today, the plant had received $202 million. That is 80% of the cost of the platform. The rest will be transferred after the rig is operational.
Now pay attention to the surrealism of Ukrainian corruption. While saying these words, Yevgen Bakulin demonstrates bills which show that the money had been transferred to the British offshore intermediary Highway Investment Processing, not the manufacturer Keppel in Singapore. So where did the money actually go to? Where the Naftogaz chief says it did, or where the bills say it did? And another thing, who is this cheap manipulation aimed at? This is what we decided to ask the boss of all the fuel and energy complex of the country, Energy Minister Yuri Boyko. Mr. Bakulin showed the bills. Minister.
Let me find my place first. Colleagues, we have a briefing afterwards.
The minister has agreed to answer one question.
I did not.
Mr. Bakulin said on Channel 5 that the money was transferred directly to the Singaporean company, but he showed bills that say that the money was transferred to the intermediary created for this tender. How can you explain that?
One more time.
Do we get the impression that the high-ranking official is hiding something and is just playing dumb? Exclamation mark doesn't mind repeating the question.
Yes, the $200 million was transferred to the Singaporean manufacturer. It began on the 27th and we will have the rig on the 7th. Hi, we need to have a talk. Thank you.
The bill says that the money was transferred to the intermediary.
Listen, why don't you take your bills and... Please, this is just a piece of paper. It could be a menu from a restaurant. Go to Bakulin and ask him.
If we take away the emotions, this is what we get in the end. Minister Boyko and his subordinate, Naftogaz chief Bakulin, both say they have transferred the money directly to the Singaporean plant. At the same time, they show bills which prove that the money went to a corrupt intermediary, created specifically for the tender. The most interesting thing is the amount. According to the bill, Cardiff had received a prepayment, 80% of the $250 million. But given the existing evidence that highway investment is a fence controlled from Ukraine, designed to increase the price of the goods, is there any guarantee that this was the only transaction and more money had not been transferred to Cardiff? Is it that difficult to conduct several transactions while publicly showing just one of them with the desired amount? A whole array of official documents, doubled by the clumsy and futile attempts to hastily hide the truth, convinces us even more that high-ranking officials may have been thinking of making big bucks on the purchase of a strategically important drilling platform. This seems obvious to everyone except the General Prosecutor's Office, which has not reacted at all to the press article, although it should have immediately initiated a criminal case. We will monitor the developments and will tell you how this corruption scandal, unprecedented by its scope and arrogance, unravels.